But of course he was forced by the evidence of his own music to hedge over and over again on that famous statement I quoted, to modify it and rephrase it. And even so, there's still this further contradiction. If his musical philosophy was so puristic, why was he so attracted to the theater, so devoted to the ballet, to the setting of words, all extra musical elements? If music can't express anything, well, but why go on? The crucial point of all this is that both Stravinsky and his Adornish detractors refused to acknowledge the power of that X factor up there in the magic circle, the extraordinary power of dramatic irony that could be generated by those egregiously ill-matched components. Stravinsky tried to deny it, but his music insistently confirms it, right? We are grabbed by that music. There's no escape from it. As for Adorno, he simply failed to perceive it at all, seeing it only as cleverness, showbiz, theatrical know-how, which was also true in a way, but not seeing the real meaning, which is the amazing proximity of comedy to tragedy in our time. He completely missed the joke, the big existentialist joke, which is at the center of most major 20th century works of art, namely, the sense of the absurd.